Hey there, my name is John Broadwell. I'm a medical device development and embedded systems consultant at my company, Broadwell Consulting Incorporated. And as of September of 2024, I've got some capacity to take on new projects. So if you need help with an embedded systems, PCB, Autodesk Fusion project, give me a call. This is the next video in a whole series where we took a part and are taking it all the way through production, creating a case, and so on. And today we're going to be looking at how we're going to use Autodesk Fusion with a PCB that we previously created, and how we're going to build a case around that PCB without making almost any measurements. We're almost entirely going to derive the shape and proportions and supports and whatever for the case all off of projections from the PCB. So watch for how we do that. If you're just getting into this, this video is in prior videos, we took a part that we got off of AliExpress with no data and built a 3D model. We made a symbol, we made a footprint for that part. We made a schematic that used the part. Then we built a PCB board from that schematic. We sent the board to fab at JLC PCB. It came in, and now we're designing a case. And in the final video that comes after this one, we will connect up to it in Arduino. So be sure to like and subscribe so that you can get notifications when all of the videos for this series come out. So here we have the PCB that we made in the fifth video of the series. And first thing I notice is that there's a header in JP1 that isn't there in the real board. So we're gonna go under bodies and turn off that header. Next, we're going to do a sanity check from the bottom of one of the pins to the top of the package to generally see that our scaling is right so that we can 3D print around these objects. 7.48 matches up very close to what I measure with the calipers, so we're good in that regard. Let's start looking at how to create the 3D printed case. We'll start by going under Assemble and say New Component. And then within that component, we will create a sketch. For our first sketch, we're going to use the project feature in Fusion to get the edges of the circuit board. And this is really important. One of the things you're going to notice is that as we do this, we're not taking almost any measurements. We're drawing them directly off of the circuit board that already exists. So we're going to project the edges. Next, we have to make sure that the circuit board that we create actually fits inside of the case. And there are some manufacturing tolerances. So we're going to add an offset of 0.5 millimeters to all the directions and act like the board is slightly larger than it is. That'll give us a little bit of slack just in case the tolerances are off by a little bit. Thinking about our 3D printing, actually 0.7 maybe makes a little bit more sense because we know that we're going to be using 0.3 millimeter print rails. And so 0.7 is a little bit more than two of those, or 0.6. So we'll do that. Now we're going to make the bottom of the box. And we're going to take and extrude it up. We'll make it 1.5 millimeters thick. And we're going to place it a half a millimeter above the top of our tallest feature, which is the chip. Now, in your mind's eye, you may say, oh, that's the top of the box. But really, this is what we're going to print on the bottom, because we're going to want the box to print upwards with a small amount of printing over the top to finish it up. So what is the top of the circuit board, we're going to turn upside down to be the bottom of the case. So here you can see we're extruding at 1.5 millimeters. We're going to say OK, and we're going to rename that body as bottom, because it will be the bottom of our case. Next, we're going to want to make the top of the box, and we'll use the profile of the box bottom, and we will extrude this up 1.5 millimeters as well, and we will base it on the tallest feature on the bottom of the circuit board, which is in this case where the pins stick through. So we'll take the top of that pin and add a half a millimeter worth of clearance and go from there. And we'll rename that body top because it's the top of our box. Next, we're going to grab the bottom profile again, and we're going to do what's called a thin feature extrude. And that's when you want to draw a wall of a given thickness around something. So we're going to create a thin feature that goes from the bottom out of the bottom of the case to the top of the case around the outside. And again, we will give those thicknesses of, in this case, 1.5 millimeters. and we'll rename that body as Sides. Things are starting to come together. You can see the outline of the knobs on the circuit board sticking through the case. We'll make holes for those later. It looks like our proportions are about correct. Next, we're going to want to make mounting posts for the circuit board on our box. So we're going to create another sketch that's on the bottom face, and we're going to use the project feature to project the four mounting holes onto that sketch, which we will then extrude up to the circuit board. Watch as I do this and make note of the fact that never do I have to tell it how far from the bottom of the case to the circuit board is that measurement. As I do the extrude going forward, it will automatically do it from the top of one object to the bottom of the next object. With the sketch, I do have to tell it how big I want each of the bosses that come up to be. I'm going to use the holes that I created here to get the center of those circles, but I'll have to specify it myself. Then when we build up a second boss that is a post that goes through the middle, we'll use offset for that to get it off of the interior of the hole. I'll also create a similar set that extend downwards from the top. These will overhang a little bit, so they won't 3D print super, but it'll work out, because it's only a small amount of overhang. Next, we're going to take all those holes that we put for supports in the circuit board and create bosses that go up through them. So we're going to create another sketch, and we're going to project the holes onto that sketch. So now let's take that sketch and let's extrude it up from the bottom of the case to the top. Then to neaten it up, because it creates a lot of different bodies, we want them to be bodies. We're not going to do a join because we're going to have another operation to do in a minute. Because we created so many different bodies, we're going to put them in a group. Now currently those bosses are exactly the same diameter as the hole, which means there's a good chance they won't actually fit. So we're going to select them all using the paint tool, and we're going to use the offset face to make each of the cylinders slightly smaller in diameter so that we guarantee that we create something with the 3D printers that'll actually fit through the holes in the PCB. Now we've got a huge number of different bodies all floating around. Let's grab the bottom of the case and combine it with all of those pegs that we created using the combine tool. And from that, we will create a single body out of all of those bodies. Now, as we change the visibility, we can see that our case is really starting to come together. It looks like those pegs are going to come up perfectly through all the holes that we created. Next, let's re-enable the sides and let's cut holes in the sides so that those knobs don't interfere so that they can come out and we can actually manipulate them. Again, we're going to liberally use the project tool to add features from the circuit board to the sketch so that we're not just guessing at things or using measurements that we take with the calipers or off of a drawing. They're actually tied together, the circuit board and the case that we're creating, through the projections that we're making. And if we would move that circuit board or move the knobs on the circuit board, then automatically these holes would adjust when we pulled the new revision of the board into this drawing. And in this case, we're going to use the sketch offset on the outsides of those holes that we're going to cut so that we have a sufficient clearance around the knob that there won't be any interferences when it moves. Next, we'll add another cut in the side of the case to facilitate shoving the DuPont wires through and connecting them up with the jumpers. Again, some of this is going to be based on projections. Finally, I'm just going to freehand a couple of arcs that we're going to extend onto the case to add as finger marks or handles or whatever you want to call them. And then as a secondary thing, we will also add the letters A, B, and C among the various knobs so that later on, if we're writing documentation to use this user interface that we're creating, then we'll have some way to refer to those. Again, that's using the emboss tool on the top. Now let's save it as an STL and import it into Cura. In looking at the print profile or the print preview, I noticed that I have a problem with a couple of my profiles. You could see the hole in between the center post and the boss that is the support for the PCB. So let's go back into Fusion and fix that, then re-export. That looks good. So now we're going to go back and we're going to look at the print preview and find out what the last layer is before we start to print the top of the supports around those posts. And we're going to go into the post-processing scripts and add a filament change at that line. We don't actually want to change filaments, but we do want the printer to stop so that it'll print most of the case. Then we can drop the PCB in place and finish printing over the top. We'll reinsert the filament, tell the printer to resume, and it'll print the top on the case with the PCB sealed inside. Pretty cool. After printing my first sample, I realized that I should have added fillets at the bottom and around some of these bosses to make them a little bit sturdier. I also realized that the knob interferes with these PCB support posts, and so I'm going to make some quick modifications on part of those posts so that the knobs have full ability to rotate. Let's 3D print it. And we can see here it stopped and gave us a chance to drop the circuit board in. We'll reinsert the filament, hit resume, and print over the top to complete the case. And it's finished. In our next video, we will test it out by connecting up to it with an Arduino sketch. So hit subscribe so that you can see the final video in this series. Broadwell Consulting Incorporated provides help developing medical devices with a focus on developing embedded firmware, which is compliant with IEC 62304, ISO 14971, and ISO 13485, as well as remediation assistance for products already in production. For more information, contact John at Broadwell Consulting. Support requests for Serial Wombat should be sent to help@serialwombat.com and will be answered on an as-available basis. Also, feel free to leave your question in the comments below.